Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Today we're taking a look at another antique telescope. This one made by the Clarkson company in London around 1890. It's a 3-inch achromat and we're going to take a look at some of its features. I managed to pick it up for £60 at an online auction, and just for this tube assembly. And I think when you pick it up, it's 3.5 kilos of brass. Seems like a pretty good deal. Now firstly, back to the maker. Alexander Clarkson bought an existing optical manufacturing company back in the 1870s. Later on he went into business with a Robert Broadhurst, and after a falling out between the two, Broadhurst went his own way and started trading as Broadhurst Clarkson and Co. from 1908. So we know that this telescope predates that. Certainly I'd say it's probably 1890s to 1900 thereabouts. But the interesting thing is that it's a Clarkson scope and not a Broadhurst Clarkson. There are far fewer of these Clarkson scopes around compared to the BC scopes, probably reflecting the manufacturing volumes of the time. So next thing we're going to have a look at is the optical layout of the scope. So the scope was supplied with one of these. It's the eyepiece, believe it or not. It's a terrestrial eyepiece. So why is it so long? Well, it's quite a lot more behind the scenes than initially meets the eye. So if we take the end off the tube, firstly we find that we have just a cover, and then inside we have a cartridge eyepiece, which you can see, I hope, one of the lenses at this end and the eyepiece end that we see is there. So the whole thing's about 2 inches long. And then at the other end of the tube, so this is the end that's closer to the objective lens, there's another threaded assembly inside the tube, like so. So again, we've got another arrangement of lenses. And the combination of all this put together flips the image right way up for daytime use, and it's probably the equivalent of a Poro prism and a conventional eyepiece. But back in the day when these scopes were produced, there were dedicated terrestrial eyepieces like this one, terrestrial tubes as they were called, and there were separate astronomical eyepieces which would look more conventional, I suppose, to a modern eye like this. So taking a look at the focuser, we can see that we've got a focusing knob on the side of the tube which is acting to move with an internal rack and pinion mechanism. It's moving the focuser tube. This one moves by, I'd say, about only 6 centimeters, and as is common of these old scopes, and indeed a feature you've seen on scopes up until the 60s and 70s, you also have secondary a coarse mechanism for achieving focus in the form of a push-pull draw tube here. So you have to do a bit of adjustment initially with the push-pull and then fine adjustment like so. The mechanism itself is secured inside the brass tube with 3 screws around the outside here. So we'll take those off and have a look inside. Now if we first remove the focusing knob from the side of the tube and then those 3 screws, then we're able to pull out the focusing mechanism and the draw tubes like so, and this reveals the rack that is screwed onto the side of the focusing tube. And you can see quite easily how the rack and the pinion operate against each other to focus the telescope. So other points of interest, if we have a look inside the tube, we can see, I hope, that inside the end of the tube there is a baffle, and there's a slot. There's a slot cut rather crudely into that baffle to allow the focuser rack to move in and out. And then finally on the scope, something that's worth taking a look at is the objective lens, obviously always the most important part of any telescope. I came to look at this lens to see how I could remove it, and started off by turning side to side, thinking it was threaded, but actually it turns out that it's not. The entire objective cell is just pushed into the end of the brass tube, and it's held in place with friction. So there you go, there's the objective lens. So this is a typical achromat of the day, 76mm. No obvious marks on the outside, which I was hoping to see, but doesn't really matter. No obvious coating, but I guess we'll wait and see when I've used this scope a bit more. During the day it performs pretty well. So there you go, a push fit objective lens cell. So that's it, something for a summer's day. Buy an old scope, take it to bits. So a brass tube with a couple of baffles and a bit of black paint, a nice sliding push fit objective lens assembly, rack and pinion focuser, focusing knob, and a terrestrial eyepiece tube. That's it. It's been a Clarkson 3-inch refractor we've been looking at today. Hope it's been interesting. Thanks for watching.